Smash Ultimate has some broken attacks. From Wolf's Snare to Palutena's back air, there are just some moves that make you feel like you're not even losing to the player or their character, but just that attack. Likewise, however, there are just some pretty terrible moves that just don't achieve much of anything, or they carry too much risk to warrant their small reward. These can be pretty interesting to look at, because unlike any of the best moves in the game, bad moves are hardly ever used and thus easily forgotten. In this video, we're going to be exploring some of the most awful attacks in Smash Ultimate and share some insight into why they're just so bad. We've gone over this topic in the past, but figured it would be a good time to update the list after the plethora of balanced patches that definitely changes the ranking. Before we kick it off though, let's hear from you. What do you think is the worst move in the game? Pause this video, comment below, and then continue to watch the video and see if great minds think alike. For even more moveset insight, you can check out the Smash section in our website proguides.com. We've got breakdowns on every character so you can learn more about your main. And while you're there, you can just get yourself a pro coach to help you improve your gameplay. To take it even further, our site features exclusive Smash courses with top players such as MKLeo and ESAM. We've also recently launched live classes here on our YouTube channel. You can check out these free live classes right here on this very channel Monday through Friday at 12 PM Pacific time. Make sure to subscribe to the channel with notifications so you know as soon as those classes go live. So, bad moves are often found on bad characters, but there are examples of great characters with some exceptionally bad moves. Let's start off with Jigglypuff's rollout. Smash 64 featured only up, down, and neutral specials, so Melee added new moves to all the original characters. They clearly missed the mark on Jigglypuff's rollout as it's one of the worst moves in the game. In Smash Ultimate, it takes a good amount of time to charge the move to a point where it has a hitbox at all, and once it does, this move is extremely reactable and can be avoided by simply jumping. When fully charged, this move does a good amount of damage, and hitting a shield with two rolls will break it, but you need to have the reaction time of a pickle to let any of that happen. Little Mac is almost universally agreed upon to be the worst character in Smash Ultimate. Despite this, he actually has plenty of amazing attacks, but also some atrocious ones. In Mac's case, listing just one move isn't good enough. Every single one of his aerials could be listed among the worst moves in the game. These pathetic arm flails were literally intended to be borderline useless, and the developers clearly did a fantastic job of meeting that goal. What's pretty interesting is that Mac's neutral air is actually tied for the fastest aerial in the game at frame 2, the same frame as Brawl Meta Knight's up air, and he can do 3 nairs in a short hop, but unfortunately the hitbox is just so puny that it doesn't even matter. Mac's aerials aren't his only horrible move. His neutral B, well, when he doesn't have the KO punch, is a straight lunge, which like rollout is an obvious move that takes a long time to charge before it can accomplish much of anything. Its armor frames make it somewhat useful to break out of combos, and it can be cancelled into the shield after a while, but this gives the opponent time to punish in most situations. Captain Falcon is one of the most exciting characters to watch and play in Smash Ultimate. His fast movement, flashy combos, and deadly knee makes him a bona fide crowd favorite. Sadly though, his Hypheus attack is also his worst, and even one of the worst moves in the game. Yep, we're talking about the Falcon Punch. At frame 53, Falcon Punch is one of the slowest moves in the entire game. Not to mention it has over 50 frames of cooldown as well. It can't be comboed into, it can't be comboed out of, and it's only slightly stronger than a fully charged forward smash. So, you'd pretty much only use this move as a disrespect option or for shield break punishes. And even then, you could probably get more damage from a combo. Samus and Dark Samus have been more prominent characters in the current meta after receiving some notable buffs in the recent patch. They excel at zoning and long-range gameplay, keeping opponents out with the projectiles and Zare. Samus isn't the best at boxing, but down tilt and up B out of shield give her some capable close-range options. Her jab, unfortunately, isn't one of these. If we were talking about jab 1 by itself, some credit could be given by the mix-up of going for a pivot grab afterwards, but coupled with jab 2, this move is terrible. The in-game tips even address this, stating that it's safer to just hit with the first attack and then flee. Why would the developers knowingly create a 2-part jab combo that doesn't connect almost ever? We're not sure, but it's certainly one of the worst moves out there, and even after jab 1, opponents who know the matchup can just roll or jump away to avoid the pivot grab. When discussing moves, it's natural to think of attacks and special abilities, but grabs and throws are also part of the character moveset as well. Among the worst throws in the game has to be Roy or Chrome's back throw. This throw has such little knockback that it barely even sends the opponent anywhere at 200%. Its hitstun is way too low to offer any combo potential, with lots of lag making it close to negative on hit. It might still be the best throw to go for sometimes if you just want to get your opponent off stage, but Roy and Chrome will almost always get more reward from down or forward throw anyway. While we're on the topic of grab and throws, Cloud has an exceptionally slow grab in Ultimate. At frame 9, his standing grab is even slower than Bowser's, which is strangely inconsistent with Smash's general trends of character archetypes. This makes his shield grab frame 13 the same frame as his pivot grab, and his dash grab is frame 12. This hurts Cloud a lot in the competitive meta, especially because he doesn't get much of anything from his throws, so players can get away with just holding shield a lot against him. Yoshi is infamous for being one of the mashiest characters in Smash Ultimate, but interestingly, he has one of the most terrible moves that's probably the most commonly misinputted by Yoshi players. We're of course talking about the egg roll. No, not your favorite side dish from a Chinese takeout, but Yoshi's side B. Somewhat similar to Jigglypuff's rollout, egg roll puts Yoshi into an egg where he rolls around in the direction the stick is aimed. This move is very slow, making it easy to react to, and it achieves virtually nothing when it hits. It doesn't even break shield like Puff's, and has a lot of lag when it ends. It's a bit tricky to punish, but you'll almost never see this move outside of Yoshi misinputting their egg toss. Simon and Richter's whip hold was shown off in their initial release trailer, but did anyone remember that this move even existed? Well, if you hold the attack button after a Belmont's jab or a forward tilt, then you can swing the whip freely with the left stick. This move is extremely similar to Sheik's original side special from Melee and Brawl, and it's just as useless. There's pretty much never a reason to use this move. It does have a hitbox, but it almost does nothing when it hits, so there's not much else to say, it's just a terrible move. Like Little Mac, Kirby is generally seen as one of the worst characters in the game. He also has some solid normal attacks, but his special moves are mostly quite bad. Although his down B, Stone, is a landing option that you'll need to look out for against Kirby's, its startup is reactable and even if he cancels it, it puts Kirby in a lot of lag. Unlike in Smash 4, this move doesn't have much shield break potential either. So anytime you see a Kirby use Stone, then you can just shield it or air dodge and then punish him. Stone on the ground isn't even invincible by the way, a strong attack can hit him out of it. King DDD has a lot of bad moves too, particularly his Jet Hammer. By holding D, DDD can charge his moves while walking around. His movement and jump are very slow and laggy in the state, even inspiring a popular challenge where people hold this move and attempt to navigate the Pac-Land stage. Once the charge completes, DDD will start taking damage if he continues to hold the hammer. The worst part is that it's not even that strong. DDD's forward smash is much stronger and has around the same end lag, so there's no reason to go for this move outside of a disrespect option. Hero has the most moves of any characters in Smash history, so it's no surprise that there are many good and many bad. His worst move comes in the form of a command selection option called Ka-Klang. Ka-Klang turns Hero into metal, where he can't even move or be hit for a few seconds. This will effectively stall the game while it's active, but it has a reactable cooldown window in which the opponents can release their fully charged smash. If you should make the horrible mistake of activating this move into a Hero Ditto, the other hero has a high chance of finding a metal slash, which will insta-kill any metal opponent. Unless your opponents don't know how to punish it, Ka-Klang is basically just a free charge smash for your opponent. Nerfed or not, Bayonetta is still designed as a combo character. Her normals and special moves are almost all intentionally designed to connect into one another so she can execute flashy, extended combos. She has one move though with no combo potential at all and no special uses. Bayonetta's forward tilt doesn't even combo into the second or third hits consistently, yet alone anything else, and its slow startup and leggy cooldown make it even worse. If her opponent is in the range of a forward tilt, Bayonetta can get more reward off so many more options, such as an up B, side B, down tilt, and up tilt, so there's never any reason to intentionally go for a forward tilt. Mario has some of the best moves in the game from his Nair to his Waft, and his tournament results prove that he's among one of the best characters in the game. As we mentioned, this doesn't make a character exempt from having bad moves though. Wario's smash attacks are lackluster in general, but his down smash takes the cake. It's not that fast, has very little range, and very little knockback as well. The hit detection on this move makes it only hit shield once, so it's super punishable, and Wario can get kill confirms and other combos from his excellent down tilt. So down smash should basically never be used outside of a dance competition. Ganondorf is one of the hardest hitting characters in Smash Ultimate, and in most cases, his frame data is actually pretty decent considering the power behind these hits. His up, tilt, and Warlock Punch are extreme exceptions however. They are incredibly slow and reactable. Warlock Punch is basically just a stronger and slower Falcon Punch, and up tilt is a little bit faster with the Windbox, but suffers from the same issues. The one redeeming factor of both of these is that they break shields effortlessly, but their long startup and cooldown isn't even worth it when Ganon has so many moves that are really strong and much faster and safer. As for the absolute worst move in the game, it's a toss-up between any of Max Ariel's and Belmont's Whip Hold. Truthfully though, almost all of these moves are completely useless and it doesn't really make a difference. The point is that you should almost never use any of these attacks unless you're gonna go for a style and disrespect. In which case, this list could be a complete different one with a challenge to see how many horrible attacks you can land. What do you think is the worst move in the game? Let us know down in the comments below and be sure to subscribe and click the bell for more pro guides.